Yesterday I went to my doctor and I wanted to follow up with her about the anti-depression, anti-anxiety medication I was on called Lexapro, and I wanted to talk to her about new medications, and she decided to put me on Prozac, and I just took it, so I want to talk about that experience today. What is up, everybody? This is Chris from The Rewired Soul, where we talk about the problem, but focus on the solution. And if you're new to my channel is all about helping you to improve your mental and emotional well-being. So if you're into that kind of stuff and you wanna live an amazing life, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell. So yeah, my doctor switched me from Lexapro to Prozac, and I wanted to talk about it. So I'll dive into that story. And one thing that just kind of popped up into my head, like literally after I hit record, was I've had people tell me like how, you know, like how it's crazy that I'm so open and honest and da 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 and all this other stuff. And like, I don't know, like that's interesting to me, because one of the reasons I have this channel is because like there's such a stigma around mental illness and people are like, oh, don't talk about that. Don't talk about this stuff. Like, I was legitimately in a job interview the other day and I was talking about the antidepressants and anti-anxiety medication I'm on. Like, whatever, like, it's nothing. Like, one of my visions for like where I want the world to be, and one of the reasons I have this channel, is I want it to be the same that if you're taking mental health medication as if you were taking like antibiotics. You know what I mean? Like, it's just something that we gotta do to, you know, manage our health, but it's our mental health rather than our physical health. But the mind and body are connected in a lot of ways, and that's something for another video. But anyways, like, open up, talk about this stuff, be honest. Like, I don't know. I got to a very comfortable place where I just legitimately, it's like, who cares? Let's talk about this stuff. Anyways, getting back to the story, just a little bit about my history with depression and anxiety. I'll tell you like the cliff notes, but I have a ton of videos on here. I talk a lot about getting diagnosed with a generalized anxiety disorder and all that. So anyways, basically what happened was 6 years ago, I got sober from drugs and alcohol, right? And what happened was, the reason I got diagnosed or looked for a diagnosis was, after I got sober, after almost a decade of abusing substances, I started to feel the same way I did before I started using alcohol and drugs. And what I realized was, like, I always had depression and anxiety, and I was self-medicating, and that's one of the main reasons why people start abusing substances. So I went to the doctor. My mom's a psychologist. She told me to go to the doctor. I go to the doctor, do some tests and stuff like that. I get diagnosed with a generalized anxiety disorder, as well as, like, minor depression, or dysthymia, if you will, which is like high functioning depression, right? And I've been on Lexapro for 6 years. So anyways, to catch you up to where I am today, I was laid off from my job a couple weeks ago. I have insurance until the end of the month. And like, I went to the doctor, like, so Lexapro is something I've been on for a while, like for 6 years. And what's interesting is the company I was working for, I went out to their corporate office, like I would go out there a couple times a year, and we had a genetics testing lab. And basically, like, it's really cool stuff. I recommend all of you guys ask your doctors about this or your health insurance company. Basically, they take a genetics test, they take a little spit swab, and they test it, and they see what medications you are good for you, or which medications you might have a reaction to. And when I got this list back, I'm looking and like, I'm fine with like every medication. And then I get to Lexapro, and it basically said, like, it has a scale, and I was, you know, in like the high end of having a lot of side effects from it. And I'm like, I've been on this stuff for like 6 years, and I've had side effects from it. Sometimes it's just like, I feel like I don't have as many emotions, like the full range of emotions and stuff like that, which is a weird subject, because when I'm off of it, the emotions get too much, or the sadness or depression or the numbness, you know what I mean? So that's weird. There's some other issues that I've just had as a result of Lexapro. So anyways, my insurance was up, it ends at the end of the month. I went to the doctor, I wanted to talk to her about it. And by the way, I have the best doctor in the world. I need to do a video, because I used to hate doctors in all shapes and forms. And like, the trick is to finding a good doctor, and keep looking until you find a good one. This is the best doctor I've ever had. Like, she is just amazing. And I don't know if you're watching this, doctor, but if you are, I love you. But I love her because she'll sit down and talk with me. Like, when I go there, like, for example, my appointment was at 10:45, and I was there until 11:45 until I saw her, and I just don't even care. You know why I don't care? Is because I know she's spending time with people who have questions and wanna talk to her about stuff. So like, I don't get upset when, you know, she's running late. Like, she apologized to me and I'm just like, you're good. Because then she sat down and we talked for like, I don't know, like 30 minutes. Like, most doctors I've had just like kind of shuffle me in and out. So anyways, I told her about, you know, the Lexapro, and I'm worried about some of the side effects, and like, now that, you know, and I wanted to talk to her about switching. And it's cool because we went back and forth and we talked about different medications. She mentioned, like, you know, and she's very well educated about medications, and like, she knew a lot of stuff that I did. And like, me and her talk because she knows I worked in a treatment center, so like, she doesn't like try to, I don't know, go over my head with stuff. Like, she knows she can communicate with me about medications and mental health and stuff like that. But anyways, she was saying that one of the side effects, because obviously weight's an issue, and I don't know if you've seen me, but she was saying one of the side effects for Lexapro is weight gain. And she knows my struggles with weight loss. Like, I told her, like, I was like, yo, I just went to the gym and did 2 miles yesterday. You know what I mean? I go to the gym 3, 4, 5 times a week, depending on what's going on or my motivation or whatever. And like, she gets it. She gets how discouraging it can be. I was telling her, I was like, it's discouraging because I've been vegetarian for over a year now, and like, I just do a lot of things healthier than most people do, but I still have all of this weight. You know what I mean? And she gets it. But one of the things she mentioned was that Prozac, one of the side effects is weight loss. So I'm like, okay, well, Prozac is non-addictive. It can have weight loss, and Lexapro can have weight gain. I'm like, let's go with the Prozac. So she was like, well, what I'm worried about is, she's like, you've been on Lexapro for 6 years. Like, I wanna know why you were on Lexapro. Like, why did the doctor give you Lexapro? And like, I love her because she's concerned about those types of things and talks to me. And I told her straight up, I said, basically, I've been diagnosed with just about every mental illness that my mom has. My mom's been on Lexapro, it worked for her. So the doctor, like, I told him that, and the doctor just gave me Lexapro, and that's just what I've been on. She's like, oh, whatever. So she prescribed me Prozac. So here's another reason why my doctor's amazing. She knows my insurance is running out at the end of the month. And I was like, hey, can we like see if I can get like a 3-month prescription rather than 30 days? Cause I don't know when I'll be able to have insurance again or afford it. She's like, oh yeah. And she like put it through and boom. So now I got 3 months worth. So, oh, I love her so much. Now, when we were talking about the worries about me switching from Lexapro to Prozac, I asked her this. I said, okay, well, here's something that I do and something I try to teach all of you. Whenever I get off a medication, I try to keep a refill, okay? So what I asked her was, I was like, can you give me a refill for Lexapro too? Obviously, I'm not gonna take them both, but that way, if I have like a side effect from Prozac, I can go back to the Lexapro, you know, just fine without having to like schedule an appointment and go through all that and da 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 da. And she's like, good thinking. So she gave me 3 months of Prozac and a month of Lexapro. And yeah, the Lexapro is just chilling just in case I need it. So anyways, real quick side note, I talked to her. Some of you have been around for a while. You saw that I took an ADHD test just because I could relate to a lot of the symptoms and things like that. And basically I talked to her and like, it kind of surprised me how she was saying how little the diagnosis is. She's like, yeah, like pretty much all of us, we just have this questionnaire. And if you answer yes to a few of the questions, we give you an amphetamine. And she's like, but I know you're in recovery and I know you will not take an amphetamine. So let's not even waste our time. I'm like, okay, cool. Like, I asked her, I said, are there any non-narcotics that really help with, you know, symptoms of ADHD? And she's like, no, they need to be a stimulant. So I'm like, okay, like, and I was talking to a friend earlier, like, my symptoms, if I were to have it, I don't even know if I do, I just know I have some of the symptoms. But I was talking to my friend, like, it's a minor inconvenience. Like, if anything, it helps me focus on things I'm passionate about, you know what I mean? So we just kind of got that off the table. So anyways, I spent the night at my girlfriend's house last night so I could take her nephew, no, not nephew, her cousin to school this morning while she had to go to school early this morning. So I went there and I brought the Prozac with me and I took it first thing this morning. I asked the pharmacist too, and like, I'm trying to explain the process of my experience because I'm very careful with medications, and like, I know a lot of you out there who struggle with mental illness, like, you know, there's do's and don'ts when it comes to medications, and I'm very, very particular about things I do because I used to be a prescription drug addict. So anyways, I asked the pharmacist, I was like, is there gonna be any side effects from me taking Lexapro today and me taking Prozac tomorrow? And they said no, so I'm like, okay. So I took the Prozac this morning. I was worried because I remember one time I was off of Lexapro for like 6 months, and I took it, and I just had like the worst stomach pains like all day. I was like in bed, I had to stay home from work. It was madness. But yeah, I took the Prozac this morning and like no real side effects. Like it feels fine. I feel the same as I did yesterday after taking my Lexapro and things like that. So I don't know, like I wanted to make this video to kind of talk about my experience about why I switched to Prozac. I haven't gone through a full 24-hour cycle, but I'm thinking about like documenting this experience and talk about, you know, is this weight loss, weight gain like something that's real? Like, do I start to notice that I shed more pounds now that I'm going to the gym and eating healthier, now that I'm on Prozac rather than Lexapro? You know, I wanna see how it manages my anxiety and my depression. One thing that I was concerned of is like, Lexapro, like I'm primarily somebody who has anxiety, but then minor depression. So like, I'm curious if the Prozac is going to help manage my anxiety as well. But those two things are very intertwined, so I expect it will. But I wanna document this and talk to you guys, so any of you going out there, but I do wanna kind of end the video with this. All of us are different. All of our bodies are different. Some of us react a certain way to medication. Some of us don't. I've had people in my last video about like, when I talked about why I hate anxiety meds, like, or my depression meds, in the comments you see a lot of people where they had like a bad experience with one, so they just don't wanna do it anymore. Like, you guys, listen to me very carefully. You gotta prioritize your mental health. And like, there are so many options for antidepressants and anti-anxiety. Just because you had a bad experience with one doesn't mean you'll have a bad experience with another. Again, I will remind you, ask your doctor, ask your insurance company. They have genetic testing to see which medications you will respond better to, okay? But do not give up on mental health medications just because one of them didn't work out so well. You know what I mean? So find a good doctor, do what you gotta do, but prioritize your mental health. Like, this is a big deal. It's hard to live any semblance of a happy life when your mental health is struggling. But anyways, down in the comments below, let's do this. Are any of you taking Prozac? What was your experience? Good, bad? Like, let's see the whole gambit of, you know, or what antidepressants are you on? You know what I mean? Like, again, I wanna make this more of a normal conversation. Like, let's talk, let's have a discussion, let's decrease the stigma and increase awareness. You know what I'm saying? Actually, that gives me an idea for the ending of this video. Check this out. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you are new here, I'm always making videos to help you out with your mental health. Make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell. And a huge thank you to everybody supporting the channel over on Patreon. There's a new name on the list. Thank you much. And if you wanna check out the Rewired Soul merch shop, you can click or tap on that icon right there. And then right over here is a shirt that I designed that says, mental health, increase awareness, decrease the stigma. Get yourself one. Let's do this thing together. All right, thanks so much for watching. I'll see you next time.